Sup, Rotten? So I don't know if you heard, but there's a new macOS update coming this year called macOS Sequoia. And even though it's coming with some brand spanking new features that make macOS more useful, doesn't mean it necessarily covers all of the bases a proper Mac user would want or need. So today, I'm going to put you onto a few Mac apps to help enhance your Sequoia experience. And I know some of you non-Mac users still watch my videos anyway, and I appreciate you. I have a little something for you PC guys too. Now let's get into the apps. So one feature coming to macOS Sequoia is window tiling, where you can now rearrange your open windows or tiles and snap them into any order you want natively. So you no longer need a fancy third-party app unless you want some fancy features, like in my last app video. Fun fact, the reason it took so long is because Microsoft actually had a patent for window snapping that they filed in the early 2000s, so the Mac legally couldn't have it natively. That's diabolical as hell. Anyway, neither OS can take it a step further. Like this app called Hazeover. Having so many app windows open can be a bit overwhelming. And if you have an Apple Silicon Mac, you can now have more app windows open than ever before. Thankfully, Hazeover helps out in this department by giving you the ability to dim your background so you can focus on the task at hand. You can manually adjust how dim you want your background for each app or use a keyboard shortcut, a must-have if you get easily overwhelmed or distracted. One thing that isn't overwhelming or distracting though is subscribing to yours truly. For every one person that subscribes, an apple somewhere in the world turns rotten. So help me ruin someone's day by hitting that subscribe button and supporting the video. Now, some of you may have heard that the iPad is now getting a calculator app with its new update, allowing you to write and draw problems using a feature called Math Notes. Though Mac won't have that feature, at least not to my knowledge yet, that doesn't mean Macs can't have a cool calculator of their own. And that's where Numi comes in. Numi is this beautifully simplistic looking app that combines the formatting of your notes with a calculator. So now you can keep track of all your equations if needed, and on top of being a terrific basic calculator, it also does things like convert and calculate unit conversions and everything else seen here. Its ability to read Markdown makes it extremely useful and intuitive for people laying out elaborate calculations. But at its root, it's just this cute little calculator ready for just about anything you throw at it. Now I know one factor that deters PC users from giving Mac a try is storage compatibility. If your drive is formatted specifically for Windows, then having a Mac being able to read it is pretty much impossible, as the NTFS format was designed specifically for Windows, and the APFS format was designed specifically for Macs. However, you can now bridge the gap with NTFS for Mac by iBoySoft, the sponsor of this video. That's right, drive formats like NTFS are Windows specific, and there are a lot of benefits that come with it. But with NTFS for Mac, you no longer have to compromise security and exclusivity if you work on both PCs and Macs. This powerful app utility allows you to both read and write on NTFS drives just as you would on any other drive on your Mac, as well as natively reformat drives as NTFS directly on the Mac, which is super convenient, especially for the nerds out there that use both systems fairly regularly, whether it's for work, play, content creation, etc. So if this interests you, feel free to check it out in the description below. And shout out to iBoySoft for sponsoring this video. As much as the Notes app is getting an upgrade, accessing it just isn't quick enough when you need to quickly jot down whatever comes to mind. It's a good thing apps like Side Notes exist, where it subtly sits on the side of your screen, just ready to go with a quick click or keyboard shortcut. It's a nifty notes app that has a little bit of everything for everyone, like giving you the option to change the color of specific notes, create checklists, and even add pictures. Did I mention that it also reads Markdown? And thanks to iCloud synchronization, it'll seamlessly sync between its respective iPhone and iPad apps too. A powerful notes app with no compromises, sitting right on the side of your screen, ready to go as soon as you are. Could you believe that we are already coming up on macOS 15 and still no other settings besides setting the resolution if you have multiple monitors? It's a shame, really. Good thing there's an app called Monitor Control to the rescue. It's a very straightforward app that sits right in your menu bar, giving you more control over your monitors by allowing you to adjust the brightness and audio of each individual monitor. As you can see, every screen I use is different, so it's good to be able to adjust each monitor to my preference without having to jump into any of their built-in settings and potentially mess anything up, because with my luck, I definitely would. Would you believe that to check the battery status of your Bluetooth devices, you have to click the Apple icon, choose System Settings, click Bluetooth, and then see the list? How inconvenient is that? This app called AirBuddy makes this process way less annoying by giving you the list of your connected devices right in the menu bar, including other Macs also running AirBuddy. And it can even send you battery alerts if any of them is ever running low on juice. Not only that, but if you have AirPods, you can also see them displayed right on your Mac as you would on your iPhone or iPad. Don't ask me why that isn't a native feature yet, because I couldn't tell you. On top of switching Bluetooth device control between Macs with its built-in handoff feature and shortcut support, adding this app to your arsenal is a definite no-brainer. And that's just a few apps to make your Sequoia experience that much better. Any other apps you have in mind? Let me know in the comments. And shout out to my Rotten Pro patrons, Vasco and French Gobek, for supporting me on Patreon. Relevant links will be provided in the description below. Thanks for watching. And if you want to see more of me, you know what to do. One thing about me is I'm going to look for some Mac apps. I go out my way to look. It's a hobby of mine. So if you really do want to see more, just let me know. I have no problem looking for more. Maybe it is a problem.